So in this video, we are going to be kind of doing more calculations. We kind of ended the last video abruptly with promised calculations. So here are some workings with weak base solutions for this lesson series. We're just going to do several. We're going to start with this one. In this problem, we're going to be learning to calculate the pH of a solution. We're going to be giving you the pH of a solution, and from that, calculate the value of KB. So let's start by writing the reaction that we're considering the equilibrium constant for. It tells me that the base is C2H5NH2. Now, what does a weak base do? Well, when you place it into water, it does the weak base thing. So I do the equilibrium arrows. That represents it's a weak reaction. It doesn't go to completion. The base is a proton acceptor, and it accepts it there attached to the nitrogen. So it becomes NH3, and it's an H plus it's accepting, so it gets a positive charge. That's aqueous. And the water, which I should have put an L after, the water is the donor. So if it donates its H plus, we are left with OH minus. And every time we have a base in solution, that is going to be the product. Now, I'm going to leave some room for an ICE table and go ahead and write the KB expression, because this is what I'm going to use in my calculation. So it's products over reactants. Here's my products over reactants raised to the power of their coefficients, and we don't include liquids. Now, we are trying to determine the value of KB. So if I knew at equilibrium the values for each of these, I could know that without any problem. So that's where the ICE table comes in. Now, it tells me how much I'm putting in there initially. It's 1.2. And this is zero before anything happens. And this is very nearly zero. We can approximate it as zero. Now, before I put anything else in, I see that they gave me the pH. So I'm going to come over here and I'm going to use that pH value of, 12.41. And I'm going to be able to use this to get something in this table. When I know the pH, I know something about the equilibrium. And from the pH, I will eventually be able to, and I'll just put a box, I'll be able to get a number for what sits right there. And we're going to see why that's helpful to us. I never want to just plug in X's, unknowns, into this equation, because sometimes I don't need to. That's when I don't know the concentration values. So let's see how we do this. Well, if I wanted the OH concentration, it'd be helpful if I had the POH instead. Well, we know that pH plus POH is equal to 14. So if I put my pH in, I can solve for POH. Okay, so the POH is going to be 14 minus that 12.41, and that's going to give me a POH of 1.59. Okay, but I don't want the POH, I want the OH minus concentration. So the OH minus concentration is obtained from that value. It's 10 to the minus 1.59, and that is going to give me the concentration of hydroxide, which is 0.025, let's see here, to make sure I've got the right number, 57. Okay? So that, all of this is so I can know this number right here, 0.0257. With that number, we can fill in this table and not use X's. If it started with nothing, or essentially nothing, and ended with this, we must have done in our change line a production of 0.257. And we know that change line is this reaction taking place. So every time one of these forms, one of those forms right along with it. So I must have produced 0.0257 here, which gives me at equilibrium zero plus this number, that. And I reacted, used up 0.0257 here. And that changes that number ever so slightly to 1.17. Okay, so now I've got values in the E line, and I can go and obtain a value for KB. I will plug in the 0.02574 for this, the same number for the OH minus, so that's squared, and divide by the 1.17. And all of that to get what we're looking for, which is the KB of this acid, of this base. It's 5.6 times 10 to the minus 4. Now, before we let it go, we should think about, does this make sense? We have a small K. Weak acids have small Ks, so that makes sense. I can't really know much more than that, but if I had a positive power here, I know that I had done something a little bit off. So there we go with obtaining a KB when you know the pH. All right, so we're going to work our next problem after I come back from erasing my board. So now we're going to work a problem where I'm again given the pH, but from this I am going to determine the original concentration of the base. Now, they don't give me the formula for the base, but it's ammonia, and it's probably the only base I would expect you to know the formula for. Ammonia is placed in water, and it does what weak bases do, is a proton acceptor. The water donates. So we do our proton swap. The ammonia becomes ammonium, that ion, and the water becomes OH minus. I'm going to save room for my table and write the KB expression. It is the ammonium ion concentration, oops, that's supposed to be a 4, times the hydroxide concentration, divided by the ammonia, products over reactants, raised to the power of their coefficients, leaving out solids and liquids. Now, they gave me KB. They want to know the initial. So I'll do my ICE table. They want to know how much did you have to put in order to get a pH equal to, write it down over here, 11.22. So somehow I'm going to use my table. I'm going to use my KB expression. I'm going to use the KB value they gave me, which was 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5. And I'm going to be able to get the initial concentration. So let's just plug in things that we know, solve for things that we don't know. I don't know how much I put in. That's really what I'm trying to solve for, so I'm going to call it X. Zero here before the reaction, essentially, or very nearly zero there. Now, don't put in anything else variable-wise because they gave me a pH. From the pH again, I can obtain how much sits at equilibrium of the hydroxide. How do we do that? Well, we know that pH plus pOH. This is very similar to what we did before. We put in the pH they gave me and we solve for the pOH by taking a, that was wrong. Try again. 14, they add up to 14. Put in the pH we know and solve for the pOH value and we have a pOH of 2.78. And then what we really want is the hydroxide concentration, so it's 10 to the minus 2.78, and that is going to give me a value of 0.00166. That is the hydroxide concentration. I can come up here and plug that in. That is its concentration at equilibrium. Now, since this is essentially zero, remember, it's 1 times 10 to the minus 7. It's very, very small. We can approximate it with zero in most cases. So we start with zero and we formed this amount, so we must have produced 0.00166. If we produced that there, then we also produced it here. And we used it up on the reactant side. So this becomes X minus 0.00166. And this is 0.00166. So I've got my E line. I haven't seen an E line like this before, where the variable X came from the initial amount. So now let's plug in what we know. We know that at equilibrium, the ammonium ion concentration is 0.00166. So is the hydroxide concentration, so we can square that value. And then we can divide by the equilibrium of the ammonia, X minus 0.00166. Now a lot of you get so used to canceling things, using our assumptions that this is really small compared to this, that you cancel that out. But the reason we do that is to avoid using the quadratic. There's only one unknown x. There's no x squared. We don't need to make any assumptions or approximations here. We can just solve for it. So how do we do that? Well, we're going to multiply this to the other side. Okay, so it's going to be 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5 times x minus 0.00166, and that is equal to this value squared. And I think I've already gone ahead and figured out what that number is. It's 2.75 times 10 to the minus 6. So now we'll do the distributive property. 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5 times x, and then this times this would be a negative 2.99 or minus 2.99 times 10 to the minus 8. And that's equal to 2.75 times 10 to the minus 6. Then I want to add this to this side. It's going to be 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5, x equals this plus this number, and it just changes it slightly, 2.78 times 10 to the minus 6. Now we're ready to solve for x. We divide both sides by 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5. Okay, that will give me the value of x, and x is equal to 0.15. What is x? Always check and see if you answered the question. X is the initial amount of ammonia that you had to put into solution. That's what it asks. What is the original molarity of the solution of ammonia? So now we've solved that problem. When we come back, we'll have one more to solve, and that would be based upon this question. So I'll come back with an erase board and I will ask you that one. So we're going to determine the pH of a solution. We're given the Kb of pyridine. But before we work the problem, I want you to think about whether or not where the pH should fall. Should it be a pH less than 7, equal to 7, or greater than 7? Well, hopefully you pick C, greater than 7. Why would it be greater than 7? Well, it's a base, and when you put a base in solution, according to the Arrhenius definition, you raise the hydroxide concentration, okay? Raising the hydroxide concentration means the pH is greater. Sorry, you're raising the hydroxide concentration, which lowers the OH minus. I will say this one more time. You raise the OH minus concentration, the hydroxide concentration, that lowers the H3O plus concentration, which gives you a pH above 7. Now we're ready to work the problem, okay? So we'll actually just work it here. So I tell you it's pyridine. You don't know what the formula of pyridine is, or at least most of you would not know what the formula of pyridine is. And I can always use just a B to represent my base, and I'm going to do that. There is no reason why you can't do that for every problem. So this is my pyridine. You place it in water. Water is a liquid. You do the proton swap. A base is a proton acceptor. So if it accepts a proton, we always write it at the end, and we give it a positive charge because it's accepting an H plus. And that is one thing that's formed. And the water, since it donates, becomes OH minus. See a lot of students who memorize products. You don't memorize it, it's a proton swap. You've learned the definition of a base, have it accept. If he's a base, then he's the acid. He donates, have him donate. And these are the products you get. Again, I'll leave room for my ICE table under that, and I'll write my Kb expression. It would be products over reactants raised to the power of their coefficients. Since the coefficients are all one, that's what it looks like, and we leave out the water. Now, what do they give me? They give me the value of KB. It is 3.8 times 10. That's a times. Didn't look like it. Times 10 to the minus 10. Very small K value. All right, and I'll hold that ready. I want to know the pH. So I know that if I knew this at equilibrium, OH minus concentration at equilibrium, I could eventually get the pH. I don't know anything to plug in so far except for the initial concentration of this. They did give me an initial concentration. I examine once again. I say, is there anything else I can plug in? No, that's all I have. I've got my KB here, and I have the I line. So I know I have to resort to variables. Some of this will react. I'll call it X. For every one of those that reacts, one of these will form and one of these will form. That's my change line. The change line mirrors the coefficients up here of all being 1. This leaves me 0.5 minus X, X, and X. I know I want to know the hydroxide concentration to get the pH. So I'm ready to plug those variables into this expression. X times X, or X squared, over 0.5 minus X. Now here we see that we have a very small K. And with a very small K, we can assume that very little reactant is going to go away. So we're going to assume that X is much, much smaller than 0.5. This will keep us from having to do the quadratic. So now let's make that go away. If it's much, much smaller, then subtracting it from it won't make any difference to its value. So we can assume that it's negligible. Now we can take 3.8 times 10 to the minus 10 times that denominator of 0.50 is equal to X squared. And then we can take the square root of both sides, right? And that'll give me a positive and a negative solution. I'm only looking at the positive solution here. The X value is 1.4 times 10 to the minus 5. What is X? I come back up to my table and I see that X is equal to the hydroxide concentration. That's always an important connection to make when you're getting ready to solve for the rest of the problem, because they want us to know the pH. I can get the pOH quite easily by taking the negative log of that 1.4 times 10 to the minus 5. When I take the negative log of that number, I get 4.86. But we need to know the pH. So the pH is 14 minus that 4.86, and that gives me a value of 9.14. We go back to our previous question, which was, what is, should the pH be? We established that it should be greater than 7 because it's a base, and bases are greater than 7. It's a very weak base, so it's not a lot bigger than 7. 9.14 is a very reasonable number for this. So we have worked our way through several different calculations of weak bases. And what we're going to work on next is we're going to go back to acids again, and we're going to look at the molecular structure of those acids and how we can look at that to determine acid strength. We can say, all right, between two acids, who should be stronger based upon their structure.